Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm going to introduce you to the idea of equations that contain fractions. Now this one is a very brief introduction to that. There can get more complicated. For this particular class at this level, we're not going to do very complicated ones, but it's an introduction, and then later you take another class, you'll see them in a little more depth. There's two different methods that I want to talk about. The first method is to clear the fractions out of your equation completely by multiplying each term by the LCD. LCD standing for least common denominator. And the method number two is just leave the fractions in the equation and follow the steps to solve any other equation. Now, sometimes I use method one and sometimes I use method two, depending on what my equation looks like and if it looks easier to do one over the other. So I probably in this equation would just use method 2 and just leave the fraction in there. But what I'm doing is showing you method 1 and method 2 for three different problems. Method 1 says to clear the fractions by multiplying by the LCD. The least common denominator, well, 6 actually has a 1 there, but when you have a 1 and a 5, your least common denominator is 5. So I'm going to multiply this term by 5. I'm going to call it 5 over 1. And I'm going to multiply this term by 5 and call that 5 over 1. The reason we're multiplying by the LCD is so that we get fractions to go away. When you multiply by the least common denominator, it clears out your fractions. So what happens here, 5 goes into itself once, and so I have 1 over here. 1/5 times 5, those are multiplicative inverses, and they just cancel out to 1. Over here I have 5 times 6, which is 30x. And now all I have to do is use that addition or multiplication property of equality and divide both sides by 30. If you divide both sides by 30, these 30s cancel to 1, and I get x equals 1/30. And so I can check that 6 times 1/30 should equal 1/5. Well, it does, because 6 goes into itself once, it goes into 35 times. And I get 1/5 equals 1/5. So perfect. Even though I multiplied by 5, but I did it to both sides, so I changed them equally, and that's fine. In method 2, we just leave the fractions in and work it like we would any other equation. Any other equation, if we had this, we would just say, okay, I don't have to move any constant terms around. All I need to do is get rid of the coefficient, so I'm going to divide both sides by the coefficient. The 6's cancel here, and I just get x. Well, what do I have over here? I have 1/5 divided by 6 over 1. And if I divide by a fraction, I flip that to find the reciprocal and change it to multiplication, so I get 1 over 6. And what is 1/5 times 1/6? Well, it's 1/30, which is exactly what I got with the method number 1. Method number 2 is working the same. What you're going to have to do with method number 2 is deal with more fraction operations. That's the real difference. Okay, let's look at another one where we can use method number 1 or method number 2. Method number 1 would say find a least common denominator and multiply every term by the least common denominator. My two denominators are 5 and 3, so my least common denominator is 15. I'm going to multiply both sides by 15, and I'm going to put a 1 under that just to make it a little more clear so I can see what's going on. 5 goes into itself one time, and it goes into 15 three times. Now if I multiply, I get 3 times 3 is 9. I still have the y. And over here, I have a negative. I want to be careful not to forget that. I'm going to go ahead and write it in right now. 3 goes into itself once, into 15 five times, so I get negative 5. And now I want to get rid of the coefficient. Coefficient is the number multiplying the variable, and that's 9. So I divide by 9 because 9 over 9 gives me 1. I don't need to write the 1 there, but that's 1y. We always want that coefficient to be positive 1. And then I get a negative 5/9. So where do you write the negative sign? People will get confused about that. Why, if it's negative 5/9, it could be the same as negative 5 over 9 or 5 over negative 9. Those all mean the same thing, but we typically like to see it out front or in the top. We don't like to put it in the denominator, so one of the first two is the better way. Okay, in this problem, method one, I cleared the fractions and then I solved. Now I'm just going to do the regular method, which is get rid of your coefficient by dividing both sides by the coefficient. Okay, so on the left side, 3/5 and 3/5 just cancel out, like any number divided by itself gives you 1, so I get 1y. And over here, I have -1/3 divided by 3/5. And when I change the division to multiply and find the reciprocal of the second term, whoops, I get 5/3 there instead of 3/5. And when I multiply across, I get a negative because I've got a negative times a positive. 1 times 5 on the top and 3 times 3 on the bottom. And again, using a totally different method, I got the same answer, y equals -5/9. Up to you which one that you like. That's probably as hard as you're going to see on your homework, but I want to do one more example of something that you'll see in future classes for sure, and this one's not so bad, so I wanted to show you both methods here. Okay, in the first method, we're going to multiply both sides by the LCD, and the reason I wanted to show you this one, the LCD here is 3, because 2 has a common denominator of 1, so the least common denominator is 3, and this is the mistake that people make. They start the problem like this. This term has to get multiplied by 3 as well. You have to multiply every term by the least common denominator for this method to work. Now the 3's cancel to 1, so I get just p. 2 times 3 is 6, and over here the 3's cancel and I get 7. All I have to do then is subtract 6 from both sides. I already have a coefficient of 1, so there's no steps left. I just get 7 minus 6 is 1, and I get p equals 1. Let's look at the second method, not getting rid of fractions. You get rid of the coefficient or the constant term first. So I'm going to take 7/3 minus 2. Those cancel out, and I get p over 3 equals. I need to make this common denominator. This now is 2 over 1. I'm going to make it have a 3 in the denominator. So I would have to multiply 1 times 3 to get that. So 2 times 3 is 6. So I've got p over 3 equals 7 minus 6 was 1/3. And then I'm going to get rid of this 3 by multiplying both sides of the equation by 3. So if I multiply by 3 on both sides of the equation, because I want to get rid of that coefficient, which is actually a 1/3, then I get my 3's to cancel, and I'm left with p, and my 3's cancel here, and I'm left with 1, which is the exact same answer we got using the other method. It's up to you which method you want to use. Fractions are going to be a part of your life as you move through math. You can't avoid them, so you might as well get to know them and maybe even like them.